So are you ready, inshallah? Dawood alayhi salam, brothers and sisters, was mutamayyiz, was special. Check this out. Check this out. He was special before he was created on earth. What? Before he was born, he was special. كيف? هذا علم الغيب, this is the unseen. How are you saying stuff like that? Listen. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لما خلق الله آدم, when Allah created Adam, مسح ظهره, Allah wiped over the back of Adam عليه السلام. What happened? All the children of Adam, till يوم القيامة, they appeared in front of Adam عليه السلام. وجعل بين عيني كل إنسان من ذرية آدم وبيصا من نور. So between the eyes of every child of Adam, you were there, أنت كنت هناك. I was there, all of us were there. Allah has placed وبيصا من نور, some light into the, what, into the middle of the head, or between the eyes. Then what happened? Allah عرضهم على آدم. Adam عليه السلام saw all of this. So he said, Ya Allah, who are these people? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, they are your dhurriyah, they are your children. But then Adam alayhi salam ra'a rajulan minhum fa'ajabahu, he saw one of the lights. Imagine billions, billions of people, but there's one light that was special. One light that got Adam alayhi salam's attention, beautiful. فَقَالَ أَيْ رَبْ مَنْ هَذَا? Ya Allah, who's that one right there? From all these billions, مَنْ هَذَا? قَالَ هَذَا رَجُلٌ مِنْ آخِرِ الْأُمَمِ. آخِرِ الْأُمَمِ, this man is one of the last people to come in the later nations. ويقال اسمه داود. فآدم عليه السلام said, this is Dawood? Yes, that's Dawood. Comes from a later nation. He said, Ya Allah, how old did you decree his life to be? كم جعلت عمره؟ قال 60 سنة. Allah said, I made his life reach up to 60 years old. So then the Adam عليه السلام says, أي رب زده من عمري خذ مني. Take from my life, يا الله. 40 سنة. Take from my life 40 years and give it to Dawood عليه السلام. So instead of him living 60, make him live up to 100. Allahu Akbar. This is the authentic narration in the Tirmidhi. So we will now go past that period. Allah created Adam. Al-Adam عليه السلام came down. Hawa came down. Qabil, Habil kept going down and down and down all the way until Musa عليه السلام. Allahu Akbar. But then we will go after Musa. Ready? Look what Allah says. أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الْمَلَإِ مِنْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ. Okay, so now we will talk about Bani Israel. That's how far down in the eras we're moving. Who's Bani Israel? Israel is نبي الله يعقوب. اسم آخر. Israel is Jacob, يعقوب. So Bani Israel means the children of Israel, the children of يعقوب. All right, wonderful. So how far down? إلى الملأ من بني إسرائيل من بعد موسى. So this story I'm about to share with you, where Dawood was a young man. Dawood, شاب, مش معروف, not very famous, not a prophet yet, not a king. And he was in that area. The thing about Bani Israel is that time and time they listen to Allah, and at times they do not listen to Allah and His prophet. But they very much disobeyed Allah in many instances. And the times they disobey Allah, Allah's punishment comes their way. Not just that, يَتِيهُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ. One time Allah commanded them of something, they did not listen. They said, no, اِذْهَبْ أَنْتَ وَرَبُّكَ فَقَاتِلَ. Oh Musa, you and your people, you guys go fight. So that's something about the history of Bani Israel. So now after Musa passed away, the people were sick. Sick of what? Of being weak. Of being oppressed. اضطهاد وكذا وظلم وذل. Humiliated people. Bani Israel were at such a low point in their lives. So these people, the chieftains, they went to their prophet. What happened? إذ قالوا لنبي لهم. So Bani Israel, after Musa, went to their prophet. طب ما اسم النبي? Who's that prophet? What's his name? I have no idea. Allah doesn't say in the Quran. Allah says, they told their prophet. قالوا لنبي لهم. That means I will not focus on the name, I'm going to focus on the actions being made. So let's focus on that. Bismillah. What did they tell the Prophet? إِبْعَثْ لَنَا مَلِكًا نُقَاتِلْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. They told the Prophet, have Allah appoint to us a king, a ruler, someone that can lead us, someone that can protect us and help us and get our rights back. إِبْعَثْ لَنَا مَلِكًا نُقَاتِلْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Let's fight those enemies. You know who's the enemy? Do you know who's the enemy? The enemy is not some random person. The enemy is unbelievably strong. And their leader, Allah knows his strength. That leader was none other than Jalut. Jalut was from the Amalek, from the great, huge people, strong physically in war tactic. No mercy. So they were oppressing Bani Israel. So Bani Israel said to the Prophet, ask Allah to give us a king, a ruler. Because, let me give you some history, it's okay, بس معلومة خفيف. In Bani Israel, هناك النبوة في شعب. Prophethood was in one side of the family of Bani Israel. والملك في شعب آخر. And kingship, rulership was on another lineage. So different families under Bani Israel. But they were in separate or like parallel, if you wish to say. But they were never found in the same person. عمر ما كان في بني إسرائيل, a man who has both prophethood and was also a king. That does not happen before. That's what they're getting used to. So the one who leads the army at that time were the kings and rulers and not necessarily the prophets. So this prophet of Allah, وركزوا, pay attention, he knows بني إسرائيل. He knows. عنكم تاريخ, I know your history. You guys might be hasty, rushing. You guys break promises. في خيانة, في غش, في. You guys have history. And I don't know if we're ready for this. قال هل عسيتم إن كتب عليكم القتال ألا تقاتلوا. He says, you guys are excited. Let's go fight and get our rights back. Let's go. So he says, are you guys sure you will not run away? If Allah makes it wajib, obligation upon you to fight, are you sure? So they insist. قَالُوا وَمَا لَنَا أَلَّا نُقَاتِلَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Of course, why would we not run? Oh, sorry, why would we run when we are going to fight for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Why would we run away? لا, of course we will not flee away. Not just that, bare minimum. If it's not for Allah, وَقَدْ أُخْرِجْنَا مِنْ دِيَارِنَا وَأَبْنَائِنَا. We were taken, having our homes taken away from us. And our children separated away from us. So we will go all out. We got nothing to lose. أَهْلْنَا وَأَمْوَالْنَا كُلُّ ذَهَبُ. Everything is taken away from us. So guess what happened? Do you think Allah made an obligation upon them to fight? To go to war against Jalut? نعم. فَلَمَّا كُتِبَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْقِتَالِ كَتَبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْقِتَالِ. خلاص, واجب. Now you gotta go to war and fight Jalut and his army. What do you think Bani Israel did? تَوَلَّوْا. Fled away. We just, يا جماعة, where are you guys going? I just told you, are you sure? You will be strong. Because if you break the promise, we don't want to يَتِيهُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ. We don't want to lose track of this life again and go back to being humiliated. Allah's punishment will come. I told you. تَوَلَّوْا إِلَّا قَلِيلًا مِّنْهُمْ. Only very few of Bani Israel remained. Steadfast. Yes, we'll go. They didn't run away. Do you know who was one of the names? يلا, اكتب. Who do you think was one of the few that did not run away with the rest of Bani Israel? من الذي تبقى ولم يفر مع بني إسرائيل? Who was it? يلا, ما اسمه? Type it up or say it within your family. It was none other. One of them was Dawood alayhi salam. A young man, he said, no, I'm not going. Basically, he's staying. That's pretty much what is meant by, he said, I'll stay here. So Dawood alayhi salam remains and most of them go away. And Allah says, وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِالظَّالِمِينَ. And Allah is aware of those who oppress. You might say, brother, إيش الظلم? What oppression? They are oppressed by Jalut, that beast, and his army. No. Anytime we disobey Allah, we think that we have the better decision, we disobey Allah, we have wronged ourselves. The first one you hurt when you do not listen to Allah's commands is yourself. You think that waking up for Fajr makes you tired. You think that, but in reality, you not waking up for Fajr is what makes you tired. That's what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that those who miss Fajr intentionally, they wake up lazy, kasool, wa ta'ban, bad mood, and they intentionally miss Fajr. May Allah protect us and grant us steadfastness, Amir Rabbil Alameen. Another thing to take from it is that try not to be too excited over something when you're not really well prepared. But brother, how do I know if I'm prepared or not prepared? So these people said, ibath lana malikan, send us a king so we can free the oppressed. We want to go to war. We will sacrifice our lives. Some people today, they say that. Al-yom, an afdi bihayati, I give up my life for the oppressed. We're not telling you to give up your life. But can I ask you a question first? Did you give up your money to help the needy? Money is difficult. If you're not able to give money and you're struggling, you think it's that easy to give up your life? But forget money. Forget your life. Your time. Did you sacrifice some of your time to pray for the oppressed? Did you sacrifice? So you did not spend time making dua to Allah to free the oppressors. And you did not sacrifice some of your money. You think you and I then, at that situation, if this applies to us, we will be able to sacrifice our lives? Subhanallah. So that's something to learn. May Allah protect us. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. What happens? So the Prophet knows, Iqab Allah may be coming. Allah's punishment, you guys ran away like that. So he wants to motivate them. Guess what? Guess what? وَقَالَ لَهُمْ نَبِيُّهُمْ Their Prophet said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ بَعَثَ لَكُمْ طَالُوتَ مَلِكًا You wanted a king? صح? You wanted a ruler? Alhamdulillah, Allah chose the ruler. Who is it? طالوت. Mean? What's his name? طالوت. قَالُوا أَنَّا يَكُونُ لَهُ الْمُلْكُ عَلَيْنَا How can طالوت be our leader? مستح. I don't accept this. This is a horrible decision. طالوت. وَنَحْنُ أَحَقُّ بِالْمُلْكِ مِنْهِ They said, we are more deserving of the rulership. هذا الشعب, that part of the Bani Israel, who's used to be kings and rulers, they said, no, it's us who should be the rulers, not طالوت from the general public. وَلَمْ يُؤْتَ سَعَةً مِنَ الْمَالِ طالوت is not rich, not of the elite like us. What is this? What's going on with you guys? أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم أعوذ بالله أخلاق وكبر disrespect to Allah, disrespect to the Prophet. This is the second time they fail. You will see four of them. This is the second time. May Allah protect us. What did they do? What did the Bani Israel do? They had their aql, their intellect, go face to face with Allah's wisdom and revelation. جَعَلُوا الْعَقِلْ فَوْقَ النَّقِلْ They made their intellect above Allah's wisdom. And where's the adab? When respect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they know, al-fikra, by the way, all of Bani Israel know the one speaking is Nabi, is a prophet. And they all know a prophet does not lie. Al-Nabi la yakdhib. And they know that the prophet doesn't make up stuff. And with all of that, they're still arguing. So they are running away from Jalut. صح? هم خافوا من جالوت. بس ما خافوا الله. They were scared of Jalut and they ran away. But with Allah, they faced his wisdom in a very disrespectful way. And what did Allah say? ماذا قال الله? في سورة البقرة, Allah says, فلا تخافوهم. Allah says, don't fear the enemy. فلا تخافوهم وخافوني. Rather fear Allah. This is the one who you should really be scared of. May Allah grant us hikmah. نسأل الله أن يزرع في قلوبنا الخوف من الله ومن عذاب الله. May Allah plant in our hearts the fear of Allah's punishment. Say Ameen. You cannot have hope in Allah until you fear Allah. خلاص? Done? One more time? One more time. You cannot have hope in Allah unless you fear Allah. ما حيكون في رجاء إلا لما يكون في خوف من الله سبحانه وتعالى فلا تخافوهم وخافوني إن كنتم مؤمنين. And we need to be respectful people. Because wallahi, شوف, I'm telling you something, it's heavy. جملة ثقيلة. But this is what our mashayikh they teach us. سوء الظن في النبي كفر. The one who doubts the prophet, questions his authenticity, shows concerns about his modesty, is a trait of kufr. نعم, اسمع. اسمع. وشؤم, and it brings calamities on that individual that thinks bad about the prophet, the way Bani Israel did to their prophet. Really, what kind of decision is that? Check this out. أبا سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه. Now, if you allow me, I want to go to Rasulullah Sallam's era. Okay, let's go to his time. طيب. قال بين نحن عند رسول الله. We were with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And Rasulullah was giving away the war gains. يعطي ما أتي من الغزوات. يقسم الغنائم. And there's a man, his name is ذو الخويصرة. His name is ذو الخويصرة. Okay, what about him? He came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jahazin, he went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, I'dil. He said to the Prophet, be fair. You are not being fair right now. Be fair, I'dil. What are you doing? You're giving this person and that person. Why did he give that person more than the other person? I'dil, be just. You say that to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Look what Rasulullah said. He said, waylak. مصيبتك. This is a calamity. What are you saying? ويلك. ومن يعدل إن لم أعدل. If I am not fair, then who is fair? If I will betray, then who will not betray? And listen, هذا هو الجوهرة هنا في الموضوع تاعنا, in this topic. This is what I want you to focus on. He said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, قلوا صلى الله عليه وسلم, صلوا على النبي. قد خبت وخسرت. You will be a loser and you will be a humiliated individual in لم أعدل. If أنت تعتقد أني لا أعدل, أنت في خسارة وشؤم وخيبة. If you think bad about your prophet, you will be of the biggest of losers. So when you hear رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he did something. For example, he spat, بزق. And then the Sahaba were running after, for example. And he's like, oh, that's disgusting how the Prophet do something like that. أعوذ بالله. انتبه. احترم. Respect رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Respect the Prophets. Don't do what they did. الله يبارك فيكم. Be like the Sahaba. شوف الصحابة الأدب. The best. أفضل العصور. أفضل القرون. The best generation. May Allah make us like them. آمين رب العالمين. As much as possible. Ready for this? قام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم واصطنع خاتما من ذهب. رسول الله had a ring made out of gold. Okay. Then after some time, he came on the minbar, and he says, إني كنت ألبس هذا الخاتم. I used to wear this ring. So he used to wear the gold ring. وأجعل فصه من داخل. So I used to have the rock pointing downwards. So then he took the ring out. What happened, brothers and sisters? Allah made gold, الذهب حرام على الرجال. نزل الوحي أن الذهب حرام على الرجال. So the Prophet says, he took it out. فرمى به. Then he threw the ring. Then he says, والله لا ألبسه أبدا. Rasulullah took the gold ring out. He threw it out and he says, والله I will never wear this again. What did the Sahaba do? What did they do? فنبذ الناس خواتيمهم. All the people, اشلح الخاتم, take off that ring, على طول, take it off and throw it away. الله أكبر. That's what the Sahaba did. مش قال, you know what, let me think, is it sunnah ولا واجب ولا مكروه. I know some stuff are sunnah, some stuff are wajib, but the respect they showed the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, على طول شيل الخاتم, بلا ذهب بلا بطيخ, no gold, don't worry about it. في جنة, في رضا الله, Allah's pleasure, respect رسول الله. If that's what it takes, I'll throw the gold away. So may Allah make us like them. But you know who heard this and heard and obeyed, سمع وأطاع النبي, was a young man, داود عليه السلام. So that was the second time they failed. All right, let's go ahead. So then Talut, not Talut, the Nabi, remember, في عندك الملك, you have the ruler, you have the prophet. So the prophet is telling now Bani Israel. He is now saying again, قال إن الله, he's saying Allah, اصطفاه عليكم, Allah chose him. مش مش راجع الأمر لي يعني it's not my opinion who to be the king. Allah chose him over you guys. What's wrong with you? ألا له الخلق والأمر. The one who creates is the one who commands. صح ولا لا? Yes or no? The one who creates is the one who commands. So then he gave them the wisdom, الحكمة. طب why طالوت? وزاده, check this out. وزاده بسطة في العلم والجسم. Allah blessed طالوت with such intelligence. He was very intelligent and he was very physically strong. This is a battle. It's not a game. We need someone intelligent, strategic, and all that stuff. Being wealthy may not really help right now. We need someone very physically strong. We are talking about جالوت and his army. Now, والله يؤتي ملكه من يشاء. And the Prophet is teaching them and is teaching us. جاهز? Ready? Allah gives power and dominion to whoever he wants. خلاص? So Allah can give someone, may Allah bless brother Qari' Fawaz, I believe he was our reciter. May Allah grant him Jannah. Allah istafah, Allah chose him to have that beautiful voice. For me or you to say, why would Allah give him beautiful voice? Not me. Someone else, Allah blessed him with so much money. And they were born into a rich family. Don't say, why did Allah make me be born in a poor family? اتقي الله. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he teaches us, you know what, ish'allamna al-Nabi? ارضى بما قسم الله لك. Be content with what Allah gave you. أبيض, أسود, white, black, short, tall, blue eyes, green eyes, hazel eyes, curly hair, straight hair. Whatever the case may be, your parents, whoever Allah has blessed you with, ارضى. Be content with what Allah decreed. You know what happens? تكون أغنى الناس. You'll be the richest person in the world. You have that peace, a tranquility, طمأنينة في القلب, إرضى خلاص. Why are you trying to be concerned over something you cannot change? Why would you be concerned over something you cannot change? هذا قدر الله والحمد لله على كل حال. Alright? So we do not ask Allah, من باب الأدب. We don't ask Allah. And Allah says it clearly in the Quran. لا يسأل عما يفعل. Allah says, you do not ask me, Allah, why do I do things? That's what Allah says. Don't ask, why did I do things? وَهُمْ يُسْأَلُونَ I will ask you, why did you do this and why did you do that? نسأل الله يزيدنا حكمة وعلم وانتفاع يا رب. May Allah increase us in wisdom, in knowledge and understanding. أمين رب العالمين. And the Prophet wants to motivate them. يكون فيه تحفيز. What's the motivation? Ready for this? This is really cool. This is really awesome. وَقَالَ لَهُمْ إِنَّ آيَةَ مُلْكِهِ There's a sign to help you believe that Talut is the right one. How? أَن يَأْتِيَكُمُ التَّابُوتِ Tabut, what's Tabut? Tabut is like a box. فِيهِ سَكِينَةٌ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ Okay, brother, I'm confused. What do you mean a box will come? Let me explain. Can I change my setting a little bit? Bismillah. All right. Okay. هذا التابوت, this box, فيه سكينة من ربكم. When you see this box, you will feel very comfortable. If you see this box, then know for a fact, النصر قادم, victory will come. طب, what's that box? What's in it? وبقية مما ترك آل موسى وآل هارون. This box in it are some remainings of the family of Musa and the family of Harun. Some people said, هذه الألواح. Which is the scripture or the tablets which the Quran at that time, the religious text was written on it. Some said, in it is Asa Musa, Musa's staff. In it are things that belong to the families. طب, this is amazing. This box, they used to be so inspired when they used to see it. That box was taken away from them by the enemy. Guess what? This box will come. طب, مين حيجيبه? Who's going to bring that box? تحمله الملائكة. The one who will bring this box are the angels themselves. Allahu Akbar. Al-Malaika. Al-Malaika. So do you guys want another ayah? Is this clear? Look what Allah says. شوف ما أجمل النهاية. Look at the end. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَةٌ This is a sign لكم to you إن كنتم مؤمنين. إذا عندكم ذرة إيمان. If you have an ounce of إيمان, this sign, when the angels come with the box تابوت, you're like, bro, this is it. For sure, Talut is our king. Allah chose him. We will win for sure. Guess what happened, brothers and sisters? Guess what happened? The box came. At-tabut ata. ورأوه رأي العين عين اليقين. They saw the box and alhamdulillah, you know, it helped, you know, a little bit, revived perhaps some hearts here and there, and Allah knows best. So now Talut is who? The leader, not the prophet. Talut is ish al-malik. فَلَمَّا فَصَلَ طَالُوتُ بِالْجُنُودِ. Now it's getting ready. Talut is the leader talking to the army. It's a tough battle. عَنَّ جَالُوت, his army, unbelievable, fierce, no rahmah, killers, okay? Experts, huge numbers, bigger than us, big powers, weapons, armor, shields, duru', asliha, siyuf, everything they have. We understand that. But we will do everything we can. نعمل اللي علينا. فَلَمَّا فَصَلَ طَالُوتُ بِالْجُنُودِ قَالَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مُبْتَلِيكُمْ بِنَهَرٍ. Allah will test you. في امتحان, it's test, it's training camp. There's a practice session we have to do before we face Talut. There's a test you will have to pass. What's that test? What's that water? What's going on? في نهر, there's a river. Talut says, فَمَنْ شَرِبَ مِنْهُ فَلَيْسَ مِنِّي. Whoever drinks from this river is not from us. You do not belong in this army. You failed, you leave. Whoever drinks from that river is what? Out of the army. طيب. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَطْعَمْهُ فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي إِلَّا مَنْ اِغْتَرَفَ غُرْفَةً بِيَدِهِ. And whoever does not drink from the river, then you are one of us. And there's an exception to only take a scoop, khalas, with your hand. So for example, if this was the river, that's the most water you can take. Just a little bit. Okay, bismillah. That's it. That's all what you can take. Anything more than that, you don't belong in this army. What did Allah say? What did Allah say? فَشَرِيبُوا مِنْهِ. They drank from it. لَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ. غُرْفَة, like a, no, the whole thing. They went all out. فَشَرِيبُوا مِنْهُ. إِلَّا قَلِيلًا مِنْهُمْ. Except for few people who did not drink. Very few people who only took a scoop. The rest, the majority, all شَرِيبُوا مِنْهُ. فَشَرِيبُوا مِنْهُمْ. مَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. The number of the army, al-jaysh, yanqus wa yanqus, is getting smaller and smaller and smaller. This is the third time they're losing. Third time they're failing as a whole, as a Bani Israel. Allah puts tests in our lives to differentiate as-sadiq min al-kadhib. And some of the scholars, al-ulama, they say the river is like the dunya. Al-nahar zay al-dunya. Right? خذ من الدنيا. Take from dunya just what is necessary. الذي تضطر عليه بس. بس ما تعبي بطنك وجوفك وعقلك دنيا. Don't fill your hearts and your stomachs all dunya, dunya. You'll be obsessed. You will lose. So this nahar is like the dunya. There's an example that is given about the dunya. And it says, there was a very poor guy that saw a lady, and all what he focused on was her physical features. She was absolutely physical features, top notch. So that poor man went to that lady. He says, would you marry me? تتزوجيني? Then she said, yes, na'am. So that poor man went with the lady to the court, or to the, like, the officer who can write the aqd, the contract. So when the officer, he came, the poor man said, I want to marry this lady. Please do us the marriage contract. So the guy said, this lady? He said, yes. So the officer lost his attention. He talked to the lady. He told her, would you marry me instead? Physical features, he got blinded. عمي من جمالها. Then she said, yes. So then the guy, the poor guy is like, what? What's going on? So that poor guy, he went to the judge. ذهب إلى القاضي. And he complained. He says, this guy, I went to have the marriage contract signed to marry this lady. And can you believe what happened? The qadi got angry. He brought the officer, brought the lady, asked the officer, what's going on? Then the judge, al-qadi, he found the lady. And he was taken. His mind, dhahab. He said to the lady, would you marry me? Al-qadi, the judge. She said, yes. So the poor guy and the officer got so angry, and then they went to the wali, to the leader, the ruler. فَذَهَبُوا إِلَى الْوَالِي. They said, the qadi, we came to him to solve a problem about marriage. Then he proposed to the lady. The wali, the ruler, says, who is this judge? This is nonsense. So then the lady came, the judge came, the poor guy came, the officer came, all four. So then the ruler, al-Amir, he saw the lady. Then he says, would you marry me? Then she said, yes. So the judge went nuts. The officer got angry, and the poor guy is like, what's going on in this world? So then they made a protest, mudaharat. Asqit al-Ra'is, take down the Amir, the ruler, he's corrupted. So then when the people saw the lady, the awam in nas, shafu al-mar'a, they all said, would you marry me? Would you marry me? And then she started to run away. And all the people were running after her. Then she told them, I am the dunya. You are running after me. وَلَا أَحَدْ يَمْلُكَنِي And no one owns me except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you're running after me. So may Allah protect us, Amir Rabbil Alameen. هذا لا في نقص على الأخوات, of course. But just مثال نقرأه في الكتب, something to appreciate. So here, they saw the water, they drank all out. You never know what happens. يا أخي اتق الله. Take what's necessary and never at the expense of your deen. May Allah protect us. فبدنا عزيمة, we want some self-control. طب يا أخي, how do we have self-control? How can we be able to overcome the tests? ممكن أسألكم سؤال, can I ask you a question? Think with me, may Allah bless you. Do you believe or do you think the people could have survived, the bodies, al-ajsam, could have survived if they only took a sip of water? Do you think so? Do you think they could have made it, they could have survived, or impossible? And the answer is believed here to be that yes, they could have survived, because Allah will not give you a test which you cannot pass, O believing brothers and sisters. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. So Allah will never assign you something you cannot withstand. So the best way, or one of the best, to be able to have عندك عزيمة and self-control is to believe you can have self-control. You can do it. Ana, I cannot imagine my life quitting smoking. أترك التدخين مستحيل. خلي عندك عزيمة. حرمه الله. Allah prohibited this. That means you can quit. I don't see myself مثلا praying fajr on time. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. You can change your sleeping habit. You can. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. So believe you can have self-control and Allah will help you inshallah. طيب, what happened? Brothers and sisters, the army continued to shrink. الجيش صار أصبح صغيرا في الأرقام بس عظيما في القيمة. The army became so small in number. Do we know? نعم. The army was أُلوف, was in the thousands. أُلوف and أُلوف. But we know from an authentic hadith, hadith صحيح, that the army that remained with طالوت was 300 وبدعة عشر, about 314. Similar to the number of soldiers in another battle, غزوة بدر. Decades and centuries later, the Battle of Badr, during the time of the Prophet ﷺ, the first major battle was Battle of Badr. They were 314. Same number as the army of Talut alayhi salam or radiallahu an. Okay, so they went. فَلَمَّا جَاوَزَهُ هُوَ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ So they passed that river, Talut and the believers. Guess what happened? Some people said, قَالُوا لَا طَاقَةَ لَنَا الْيَوْمَ بِجَالُوتَ وَجُنُودِهِ Guys, we can't do this. This is Jalut. There's no way. 314, مستحيل. This is Jalut. This is the army of Jalut. We are not prepared for this. لَا طَاقَةَ لَنَا الْيَوْمَ بِجَالُوتَ وَجُنُودِهِ There's no way we can face them. Another fourth failure. That the people trying to pull the believers down. Oh, you who have failed. Instead of pulling others down to fail like you, try to go up to them and be successful like them. لا تنزل من الناس إذا أنت في منزلة يعني الدنيا نسأل الله الرفعة يا رب جميعا all of us. May Allah elevate our status. So he said, we cannot handle Jalut and his army. And look at this beautiful part. يا أخي. May Allah, يا رب, أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى يا رب to grant us إيمان like the following people. اسمع. قال الذين يظنون أنهم ملاقو ربهم The people who believe that they will meet Allah الناس الذين يؤمنون بوعد الله They believed in the promise of Allah Allah promised them victory if they work Allah gave them طالوت as a king Allah brought the تابوت Allah made واجب القتال So they know if I do what I can we will win We will win and be victorious They said, كم من فئة قليلة. They are telling the people, the world, telling you, telling me. How many times, كم مرة صارت؟ فئة قليلة. A small group of people. غلبت فئة كثيرة. That beat a bigger number of people بإذن الله. كم مرة؟ So they are telling us, يقولون لكم ولي نتعلم التاريخ. To learn history. Learn the past. هذا داود عليه السلام وطالوت الملك. They are reminding the people how many, كم مرة شفتوها, سمعتوها, قرأتوها. You read, you heard, you saw. A small group of people who are on the truth, they beat the stronger people. How many times? يا بني إسرائيل, did you not hear about موسى عليه السلام? موسى who beat فرعون, have you not heard? Have you not heard about أبونا إبراهيم when Allah saved him من النار? Have you not heard? ألم تسمع؟ كم من فئة قليلة غلبت فئة كثيرة. And now أنتم أمة محمد ما سمعتوا. Have you not heard about the battle of Badr? Have you not heard of the battle of Al-Khandaq? When a small group of believers, they beat the bigger numbers بإذن الله. Then what do they say? وَاللَّهُ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. أسأل الله يكون معانا وَيَجْعَلْنَا مِنَ الصَّابِرِينَ. قُلُوا أَمِينَ. Say أَمِينَ. May Allah make us of the patient. They said Allah will always be with the patient. وَاللَّهُ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. إيش هو الصبر؟ عدم اليأس. They are the ones that never give up on Allah. They're the ones who no matter what goes on in their deen, in their life, they never give up on Allah. They are the ones when they do the dhanb and the sayyi'ah and the sin, they know Allah can forgive. They don't give up on Allah. They are the ones who, when Allah gives them a promise, they know for a fact Allah will never ever break His promise. Brothers and sisters, al-haqqu, as our mashayikh teach us, al-haqqu bila sabrin la yantasir. The truth without patience, ma fi sabr ma al-haq, ma fi nasr, no victory. You have to have the truth, that's not enough. You also have to have patience with it. To have sabr, azim, and self-control, and never ever be hopeless. May Allah grant us wisdom. Ameen, Rabbil Alameen. Say Allah, Bismillah. We're reaching the end, and nihaya. وَلَمَّا بَرَزُوا لِجَالُوتَ وَجُنُودِهِ. They saw Jalut. Wallahi, at that time, from what I read, the name Jalut, بس اسمه, his name is mentioned, people get so scared. اسمه. The army, Jalut wa Junudu, is now present. Ayn al-Yaqeen, the believers. They saw Jalut, they saw the army. What will they do? What will they do this? Will they say, I got this, guys? We went this far, we can do it? La. That perhaps Allah and exactly what they said, but the main thing that Allah katab fi al-Quran, قالوا ربنا. 911 is Allah. قالوا ربنا. They pray to Allah because they know we will never win without Allah. All the odds are against us. We have no numbers. We have no physical strength like them. We're not as physically, mentally strong in terms of actual fighting and have experience like Jalut. We do not. So they know with Allah we will win. Without Allah we will lose. So, اسمع. Never forget how weak you are. لا تنسى ضعفك ضعفك لا تنسى ضعفك أبدا. And never forget how strong Allah is. ولا تنسى قوة الله سبحانه وتعالى. You are weak, Allah is strong. Never forget that equation or that understanding in your mind. Not just that, brothers and sisters, they said in a beautiful dua, ربنا, what did they say? أفرغ علينا صبرا. Not shower us يعني with صبر. Empty the whole bucket of sabr. عَبِّينَ مِنْ رَاسْنَا لَإِجْرَيْنَا. Fill us from head to toe with patience. Ya Allah, make every cell, كُلْ خَلِيَّ صَابِرَ, patient. Ya Allah, this test of Jalut is unbelievable. أَفْرِغْ عَلَيْنَا صَبْرَ. Do you feel it? Are you feeling them? أَفْرِغْ عَلَيْنَا صَبْرَ وَثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَنَا. And make us not run away. Make us strong, make our feet firm onto the ground, Ya Allah. خلينا شجعان, brave, Ya Allah. ولا نجعلنا ممن يهرب, don't make us flee away. وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. And make us victorious over the disbelievers. Your brother, you only have about 3 minutes left. And we didn't even talk about the battle. How will you fit 3 minutes? Talk about the battle. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not give you details about the battle. Na'am? Allah doesn't give you details. After they made that dua and they took the action, the next word in the Quran after that dua, فَهَزَمُوهُمْ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ تَهَا الْمَوْضُعِ. That's it. Brother, translate, translate. And they beat them. What? Who beat who? Talud and his army. And Dawood was there. They beat Jalud and his army. فَهَزَمُوهُمْ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. That's it. Look how simple Allah put it. Do not be so busy with the results, with the nataij. Be so busy with the sa'i, with the effort. Put the effort, let the results on Allah. اعمل العليك, حط الجهد, واعرق, واشتغل, واعمل, واقرأ, read, write, listen, learn. Do everything you can. واترك النتائج على الله, leave the results on Allah. فهزموهم بإذن الله. What did Allah say in Surah Al-Insan? Allah says, وكان, اسمع, وكان سعيكم مشكورا. السعي, مش النتائج. Allah says, and your efforts are appreciated. Ya Allah. Your efforts are appreciated. And then Allah will give the results that we deserve. And Allah is the most merciful. فَهَزَمُوهُمْ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. Some of you may say, brother, but give us one detail. I know there's one detail about the battle. نعم. وَقَتَلَ دَاوُودُ جَالُوتُ. The one who killed Jalut, the beast, the massive guy, the strong guy, was none other than Dawood alayhi salam. When Dawood, he beat Jalut, they believed in Allah's promise. هذا وعد الله حق. Wallahi, Allah never breaks his promise. Allah rewarded Dawood. وَأَتَاهُ اللَّهُ جَهْزِين. Ready? Three things. وَأَتَاهُ اللَّهُ. Allah gave Dawood al-mulka. Oh, we have a new king. And we have a new king. مش طالوت الآن. The new king, الملك, هو داود. David, they move in English, right? والحكمة. And Allah made داود the prophet. What happened? The same person, نفس الشخص, is the king and the prophet? نعم. It's none other than داود عليه السلام. This was the golden era of Bani Israel is about to start. The prophet and the king is the same person. داود عليه السلام والحكمة. And the third thing Allah gave him, وَعَلَّمَهُ مِمَّا يَشَاءُ. And Allah gave knowledge, which Allah chose, to Dawood عليه السلام. Allahu Akbar. May Allah make us of those who believe in Allah's promise. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. ثقوا بالله, trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah reward us. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. طيب brother, tell us more about Dawood. You know how we will end, right? Because we know how Dawood used to pray. How he used to fast, كيف كان يصوم, how he used to read the Quran, his voice. We know his occupation, his family, how he ruled and how he judged. We have so many details about Dawood. What are they? Inshallah, we will talk more about Dawood alayhi salam next session.